That's maybe our intent as time goes on, but that's not what I'm here for. Because many people miss talents, you know, with gifts. Praise God. They miss talents. Talents is something that does not have eternal value. Praise God. Praise God. So talent is what? Something that does not have eternal value. But giftings of the spirit have what? Eternal value. Somebody might have a talent to play tennis. What has tennis got to do with going to heaven? It might be very good. You know all these people that play tennis, it's not bad. Even it's an exercise, they are good in it. Like when you see Roger Federer and all these people, they play it. Even you, if you train like them, you might not get to that level. Because it's a talent inside of them. Praise God. But there is what is called the gift of the spirit, which is your God-given ministry and assignment. God will help us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. But there is also, now, before I go further, there is also what is called calling. There is what it means when it is said, somebody is called. When somebody is called, this calling is, it has to do with the fivefold ministry. I go to scriptures. I want to lay foundations. Praise God. It has to do with the fivefold ministry. The fivefold ministry has to do with, first and foremost, the apostles. Praise God. Secondly, the prophets. Praise God. Third, the pastors. Praise God. The evangelists. And then the teachers. Praise God. These are fivefold ministry. And it's a calling. Not everybody is called into the fivefold. So don't be angry. That's the way God has made it. Everybody is sure there are only few people called into the fivefold calling. But you also all have ministries. Somebody's ministry can be sweeping the floor. It's a ministry. Yes. Cleaning the chairs. And you are doing it with joy. You don't understand. That chair you are cleaning, eh? Like somebody wrote an article, we said, clean the chair. If the anointing of God is in your life, people will sit on the chair and they will be getting healing and miracles. No, it's so. You think that by in the name of Jesus? No! Because one thing about a believer is this: anything a believer does, it always brings impartation in the spiritual world. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So, somebody can be sweeping. I heard of something of a testimony that when a child of God is sweeping his house, let me give you, for some of you that don't like to sweep. When a child of God is sweeping the house and is singing, thank you, Lord, and then you are sweeping, it's like fire is burning with that group. As you are sweeping, the Holy Ghost is transcending your sweeping. You are not just sweeping, no. You are sweeping all the occulting powers that have been laid on that floor. Are you seeing it? Everything a child of God does is powerful. I'm trying to let you know that there is something more beautiful than pulpit. Praise God. Praise God. I pray God will help us. Okay, let's go to the Bible, the Word, so that we'll be built. Because one of the things that we'll be doing right now, I will be going deeper into the Word with us. Prophecy does not build. Prophecy encourages you, okay? You don't grow by prophecy. Are you hearing me? Prayer does not grow you. You don't grow by praying. Listen to me. You want me to tell you the secret? Even if you come for deliverance service, it does not assure spiritual growth. You know what assures spiritual growth? It's living by the word, walking by the word, listening to the word. Faith comes by what? By praying. No, it's a mistake. Bible is to make a mistake, right? No. Faith comes by praying now. Yes, peace. Shall faith come by praying? By doing the Jew. No, it's so. That's faith now. But I'm coming peace. Faith coming by praying. No, it's so. Yes, now by praying. My brother, faith coming by doing deliverance. Yes? Is that not how faith comes? Or sister, Rolling in. Faith coming by doing deliverance. I mean, That's faith. Oh, and Pastor Sunday, is that not how faith comes? Is by praying. Faith comes by Jesus is telling me something that I must repent. Is it by praying? Don't you know which is a wizard can pray? Eh? You will not understand. Devils can pray. Let me tell you something. You see, Satan is very gifted. He's more gifted than all of you here. He's even more gifted than me too. Are you hearing me? What did I say? Satan is what? Gifted. But there is something Satan does not have. Satan has, you see this Bible too, Satan knows, he knows Genesis to Revelation. Satan is anointed. That's why don't joke with sin. Because if you joke with sin, he slices your head. He's anointed. He understands the works and the things of the Spirit. He understands the move of God. This is someone that was standing before him. If he puts his hand like this, the heavens will be shaking. The Lord will rise up from his throne. He's called Lucifer, the bright, the morning star. He's the one that stood before the presence of God. The mistake he made, he thought he knew God. You know, there are people you think you know, but you don't know. They only just allow you to know a little. I'm asking myself, how did Satan get deceived like this? But Satan does not have the spirit of submission and humility. Praise God. Satan wants to be the head. He wants to be up. But that's not the way of Jesus. The way of Jesus is to go low. Praise God. Satan wants to be high. He said, I'm going to increase my throne. I will make myself high. I will increase it around the mountains. I want to be like the Most High. That's what he said in Isaiah. Not be me talking about it. It's the one that said it. He said he wants to be like the Most High. Then God said, never. This will not happen. I thought God would say, I'm a humble God. Holy God. I'm too good. No, no. He said, no, it cannot happen. Put him down immediately. Praise God. We are going somewhere. Ministry. Understanding ministry. Somebody will put Ephesians. I'll not be able to recall time. I'll not be very fast. Fast reader. Ephesians 4, 11 to 13. Ephesians 4, 11 to 13. Every service will be like Bible study. I want you to pray in the word. I'm looking for people that will pray in the world. Because when you pray in the world, you will not be deceived. You will not be carried away. I'm sure some of you, that if you see somebody here that is running miracles and raise the devil, say, wow, all of you will follow and go. Because you are not mature, that's why. You cannot test spirits. You only test spirits by the word. Praise God. Are you there? Please open, sir. Or is anybody there? Ephesians 4.
That's what?
Teachers.
For the perfecting of the saints.
For the work of the ministry.
For edifying of the body of Christ.
Yes.
Did we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man?
Yes.
Unto the measure of the statue of the fullness of Christ.
Praise God. Now let me explain something to you. Listen carefully. Anybody that will sit over a church, listen carefully. Anybody that will sit over a church must have the spirit of shepherdhood. It's called a pastor. Are you hearing me? For example, if you go to prayer meeting and then you are praying, maybe you are doing, that's not a pastor. Listen, yeah, we will never do it. I will not do it. Even if you don't like it, no problem. I will not ordain anybody a woman as a pastor never is never in scriptures. I didn't see it in the word of God. I will not do it. I cannot do it. I will not go ahead of the Bible. Praise God. Listen carefully. A believer grows under the ministry of pastoralship. Are you hearing me? You don't grow under the ministry of a prophet. Yeah, but hear me, because we are trying to align what ministry is all about. You grow under the ministry of a pastor. You know why? A pastor carries a grace. Praise God. He carries the grace of shepherdhood. My sheep know me. They hear my voice. And all that they will not follow. That is Jesus speaking. Jesus is even an example of a pastor. Praise God. In short, it's like Jesus just borrows the ministry. Jesus is the true shepherd himself. But see, the fivefold ministry is a continuation of the ministry of Jesus. Are you hearing? Jesus knows, I cannot do it all alone. I cannot shepherd. Because see, let me tell you something. I say it, and I say it everywhere. You will, until you are in a church setting, you will have to grow. Don't let people deceive you by telling you, I can stay in my house, Holy Ghost will be speaking to me. Error. I can lock myself in my house. You will be missing something. Because there is a special grace God puts in what is called the ministry of a pastor. Are you hearing? It is for shepherdhood. A shepherd is one that protects. A shepherd is one that covers. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I'm just trying to lay foundations because we have different points here. Maybe Bible study, I look at pastoral ministry, membership roles, and ethics in the church. Ethics in the church. You don't know, we just do anything, just do anything. Maybe you see a leader in the church, worker in the church, just say, how far now? How are you doing? Is something wrong with you? Can you do that in heaven? So when you go to heaven, now, you just see Jesus, how far now? They will send you back, bro. You are not ready. They will send you back because there are many people, they say, oh, it's not how you do to your manager. Your manager, your boss, how far now? How far? Maybe you call your boss. Maybe your boss, maybe it's my Adeluga. And then you say, Adeluga, how far now? They don't look at you. You chase me away. Then later, you say they are persecuting me. They are not persecuting you. It's because you are lacking the wisdom of God. Praise God. Nobody is persecuting you. But you must understand the precepts. Praise God. It's not ideal for a child to call his father by his name. Praise God. It's not ideal. Do you do that to your father? How dare me? The name of my father is Joseph. I say, Joseph, how far? My father will just say, you know that that day, your life will not be the same. Because he will, my father does not, he disciplines. That's one thing I can tell you about my father. He disciplines. And maybe that's where I learned a little bit from him, because he does not use a soft hand. When it is time, he uses a hard hand. Praise God. Now, let's understand this. Understanding ministry and calling. Now, who is an apostle? Listen carefully. I said something about a pastor, but let me start. An apostle is called a church builder. Are you hearing me? An apostle is called a church founder. Are you hearing me? An apostle is called a church planter. Are you hearing me? An apostle is one that is giving the grace. He comes with, you see, when you see an apostle coming, an apostle is not source. He's coming with a power. He's coming with a dunamis. He's coming with an authority. Apostle is an authority. Praise God. Jesus handed over the church to the apostles. apostle. All of you call him Apostle Paul, Apostle Paul, Apostle Paul. Peter, all these people are apostles. Because they were sitting in a particular place, trying to order the church, plant the church, keep the church. You even hear Paul say, "Go and ordain deacons, go and do this." He gives the orders. Praise God. Now, if somebody does not have the calling of an apostle, now, he doesn't really have that power and that audacity to go into church planting. It's not just because he wants to plant church. It's a calling. 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 It's a calling. Praise God. I will still go to other ministries which are going to be helpful to us so that you understand this and understand the calling of God. Because, you know, God has given men gifts. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. Who is a teacher? So I just want to take the fivefold very briefly. Who is a teacher? A teacher is the one that God has given the grace to break the word. He teaches it with understanding. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. There are other things that he's going to know. Most times, God gives some people. Some people come with the fivefold. Some people come with two. Some people come with three. That's why most pastors are teachers. Because once God gives you a ministry, the calling of a pastor, he has to give you a teaching ministry. If not, how would you build the people? You see, that's why many people, they can't grow. You know why they can't grow? They sit under a prophet. How can you sit under a prophet? What a prophet is supposed to do to you is to be ordained. Okay, the Lord is saying you should go to Sokoto, you should not go to Nigeria, you know. You should go to Lagos, you should not go to South. You know, it's altering your step. I will explain the calling of a prophet. So, when you sit down under a prophet, you will not grow. You will not grow. You will not. That's why we have many people. They are shallow in the world. Praise God. Praise God. Any deeper life member you see today, go and check them very well. They are grounded in the world. Eh? I was once there. You know why? Because the set man here is not just an apostle. He has the pastoral ministry. He has the evangelistic ministry. Because an apostle comes with the fivefold most times. Praise God. But if you sit under a prophet, you may be the only thing you will just know how to be doing is by fire, by fire, by fire, by fire. There is somebody here, there is somebody here, there is somebody here. That's the only thing you will know. You will not grow, you will not have power to overcome sin. See, somebody can finish prophesying and go and commit fornication, sleep with a sister. What is this here? Are you hearing me? Or maybe you think you don't understand what we are telling you. You think it's by. Somebody can be working with another spirit. He will even give you right prophecy. He will tell you the name of your father and your grandfather enter this world. And the name of the one you are carrying in your womb. Then how your mother used to cook in her father's house. He will tell you all these things. But that person can still just go and finish committing adultery with somebody's wife. And the gift is just there. You are sitting down under a prophet. You will not grow. Just compare yourself with somebody that is under a pastor and somebody that is under a prophet. You will know the difference. When you see people under a prophet, which you see all around, the only thing they know is bring water. Come and carry stone when you are coming to the church. Then bring sand. Carry water. It's holy water from Israel. It's not what you want to use to get wherever. Holy water from Israel. The things that we learned in the Catholic Church, they are brought into Protestants. What we learned is what we learned every Friday. We used to have a mass called a kind of service. You must bring your salt and water in your keg. The Reverend Father will bless it. He will spray it on you, and then we go. In short, that water is a protection for me because if I keep it in my memory, I'll just spray it. No witch will touch me. No witch will touch me. You see how foolish I am because I don't know the word. And then I will carry rosary. You will even see some. They will take the wrong one. Will tie it. I used to think it was my protection in life. Because if I'm dreaming, I will see the rosary shining light for me and protecting me. Not knowing these are nonsense and rubbish and idol. Because I did not have the world. When you don't have the world, you will not grow. You will be in one particular estate. That's why you see, when somebody has the world, give him 2 years in Christendom, he's causing explosion in the kingdom of darkness. Give him, he doesn't need to stay long because he's drawing by the world. That's why I tell you, it's not by coming for deliverance. Keep growing by the word, eating the word, and see what God will do in your life. He'll do it in our lives in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. What other part I want to explain? The evangelistic ministry. An evangelist is not supposed to own a church. The work of an evangelist is go and preach the gospel. It's not your business. Go and dump those souls. Give it to the pastors. Or give it to the apostle. Because first and foremost, an apostle sits over the church, okay? A pastor takes care of the shepherd. He takes care of the shepherd. A teacher teaches them the word. An evangelist goes out to get his soul. You know, there are people that say, we go, is Jesus wants to preach? We are not preaching church. We are not preaching church. If you preach to that soul of Jesus, is he on the air? He will be saying to hear Jesus. Because I don't understand. Is he not when you tell the soul, okay, go to this Bible believing church? Then they grow by the word. When I come born again, assuming I did not, Jesus himself appeared to me. Say, Jesus here, go to that church. You think Jesus told me what he's doing to tell me to go to a church? You know why Jesus told me that? It is from that place I grew. I grew up in a charismatic ministry. If you don't know, that's how I grew up. Every time I'll be coming, Bible study, I don't come late to church. And you know, it's now, some of you are playing with God. That's why. Some of you, God is your brother and your friend, so you can play with him. Let me tell you, if you want to grow spiritually, under, is it 1 or 2 years? I saw gifts of the Spirit and a lot of things God was doing in my life. If you are focused in the church, you will grow. Praise God. It's not this one we are coming there to church. Those days, before the pastor started preaching, we are already in church. You know what we are doing? Speaking in tongues. As the man of God, we come first. I don't mean like, you know, we start our service by 6. Let me say by 5:30, I'm in church already. That's how I do. I will just go ahead. In short, when I even go next, it's like I'll be crying because it was my first time to enter in Protestant. I've not seen anything like this. So the thing was just bring me like this. Those days, if my parents to go to church, they used to lock me in the house. Jesus said, you will not go to church. I have to think of when was my parents to go to church. Some of you now are in church. I've realized something. Christians that don't go through persecution in their Christian life, they don't grow. Are you hearing me? So, the persecution you are going through in life, start thanking your God, though. God is the one doing it. Praise God. If you are suffering in your Christian race, glorify God. There is a reason for it. Because when you suffer for the faith, you will not easily be deceived. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. The Lord God Almighty will build us in the name of Jesus. So, what other ministry? Teaching, evangelists, you know, I've explained those things. So, these are where we grow. Now, in understanding ministries and calling, there are other ministries now. You can call them health ministry. Praise God. Somebody read 2 Timothy 4:5. 2 Timothy 4:5. Somebody open 1 Timothy 5:17 again. Another open Acts 20:28 again. Open Bible. Wait. I want to see everybody Bible. Raise up your Bible. Let me see. And if I don't see you with Bible here, I can tell you to leave here immediately. How do you come to the church without Bible? Raise up your Bible. And you want my fellowship? Raise up your Bible. This is why there is problem in this generation. You are carrying phone as Bible. You are carrying iPad as Bible. Is it the devil you want to cast with iPad? Inside phone that there is Facebook. Facebook, I don't even know where they are coming from, or YouTube. YouTube that they are restricting Christian videos. Praise God. If you don't have it, if you don't have the Bible, let me see your hands up. As in you don't have anyone, let me see your hands up. You don't have any Bible. Another person, you don't have any Bible. I thought we share Bible in this church. You don't have any Bible, let me see. You two, you don't have any Bible at all. One, two. You two, you don't have any Bible. I thought we had shared Bible for you before. The two of you will buy Bibles for you people. Because they are new members, so we'll buy Bible. Everybody must have at least a Bible. At least people have two or three Bibles. This is what you are using to go to heaven now. This is your sword. This is what you will use to defeat Satan. So, for the two of them, I think we have some Bibles in the and we'll show we have some Yoruba Bibles. I think you can take your Bible. Say this.
No.
Okay, we will look at that. I will look at that. But these two people, I'll first put them first because we have not given them any before, and they are new members. Praise God. Praise God. So you please remind me so that I'll put it. I will take note of that. Praise God. Okay, are you there? The scripture. Yes. Everybody, I hope I open our Bible. Put your Bible. Ah yes, I said 2 Timothy 4:5. Yes.
4:5. But watch thou in all things.
Okay.
Endure affliction.
Okay.
Do the work of an evangelist.
Okay.
And make full proof of thy ministry.
Make full proof of thy words. Or make full proof of thy profession. Maybe I'm an engineer, a doctor, maybe proof of thy profession. That was saying of your ministry. Okay, somebody 1 Timothy 5:17. And somebody Acts 20:28. Let's be fast. I don't have more time so that we can go very fast. God wants to deal with us today.
First
Timothy 5:17.
Let the elders that rule well be counted worthy.
Let the elders that rule well, okay,
be counted worthy.
Okay.
Of double honor.
Of double honor.
Especially they who labor in the word and doctrine.
Especially they who labor in the word and doctrine.
For the scripture said, thou shalt not go to the ox that traded our.
Okay, praise God. He said, especially those who labor in the word and doctrine. Who are those that labor in the word and doctrine? The apostles are there to set the doctrines of the church. That's why some of you will be surprised. I'll say, no, don't do this thing. Until when I come, I will put it in place. Some might say, is he only pastor? Yes, because I know that there will be mistakes. So, I have to meditate, either I have to pray, I have to study, I have to checkmate a lot of things before I set up a standard. An apostle sets up the standard. If somebody does not have an apostolic calling, what are you doing with planting of churches? You don't have a pastoral calling. What are you doing with starting a church? You are only leading souls into hellfire, you don't know. It's not about what you are preaching, it's about the anointing, the calling, the spirit of God, the permission of heaven, the approval of heaven. Upon your life. That's how you will lead souls the right way. Because there's something about calling and ministry. If you are doing what God did not call you to do, it does not show now. No, it does not show now. In the beginning, it does not show. As time goes on, just give it a few years, it will begin to show. Praise God. Now, let's look at even ourselves. What are the particular ministries that God has given to each and every one of us? Now, we see this well. Those that are not in my mind will be sent to. Okay. So, what are the particular ministries that God has given to men or callings? Praise God. Some people can be called to the ministry of taking care of the poor. Now, listen, every ministry you have operates in a church setting. That is the standard way it is supposed to be. Praise God. Somebody can have the ministry of taking care of the poor, orphanage, or something like that. Do you know the departments they will need? They should be in welfare departments. Some of you, maybe you are here, you like taking care of poor people, widow, you love children, orphanage. Go to the welfare ministry, the welfare department. We have welfare departments. Go there. Now, it is the pastor or the minister or the apostle. Listen carefully. Why I always say apostle or pastor is that most times an apostle always has the calling of a pastor inside of him. Remember that one thing about an apostle is that he has everything inside of him, deposited inside of him. Praise God. And you don't grow at once. You grow gradually into the ministry of an apostle. That's why sometimes I'm surprised. Somebody that has not even started church, they have not started ministry, they have not started anything, before you raise, calling himself apostle. I'm surprised. You know, there are many things that surprise me. I'm like, what have you been through? Do you know the pains of an apostle? Do you know the suffering of an apostle? There's somebody calls himself a prophet. Do you know what it means to be a prophet? Let me tell you what it means to be a prophet. You will suffer. You will be persecuted. You will be isolated. They will beat you up. You know what you want to know? It's not the prophet you see in our days today. I don't even know if we have prophets today. Because how can we have a prophet and they keep their mouth shut? They see all the nonsense the government is doing, they can't talk. Everybody is afraid now. If we talk, maybe they will arrest us. It's not that study. Somebody that has the body of a prophet, he will speak as God gives him all chance. He will not look at Buhari, he will not look at Donald Trump. He will speak the word of the Lord. We only have few people like that. Praise God. Not the one that will be fair by those people. Instead, the ones we even have today, they are even speaking in favor of the government so that the government will give them fast envelope and all is well. Nobody is talking, everybody is afraid. Have you ever seen any strong prophets in our day today that will stand against unrighteousness? Show me one. Everybody is saving themselves. Nobody can talk. Nobody wants to speak. Everybody is a good man. Everybody wants to be gentle. A prophet is rugged. He's a rugged man in the spirit and in the physical. He's a rugged person. He doesn't give a damn. He speaks the word of the Lord. He speaks the mind of God. The Bible says, if I have a prophet among you, I will speak to him through dreams and vision. But God is my servant, not so for him. I speak to him face to face. A prophet has three kinds of deeds. It's good that you chose some of these things. A prophet has three kinds of gifts inside of him. A prophet must have these three. What did I say? He must have these three. A prophet has what is called a discerning spirit inside of him. He can discern. This discernment helps him to give word of knowledge and word of wisdom. This discernment helps his prophetic anointing. Are you hearing me? A prophet has what is called the word of knowledge. So when we begin to prophesy and say, there's somebody here, that sister in your house, this thing is planted here, something is happening, it's word of knowledge. A prophet who has word of wisdom. Word of wisdom is how to apply the word of knowledge. Praise God. Then he has these three. These ones are permanent. Then the prophet must also have the gifts of dreaming of dreams, seeing of visions, interpretation. He must have the baptism of speaking in tongues. That's deep. I might not be able to go into that now because there is something about the gifting of tongues. This thought you are seeing is a ministry. Because it's similar to prophecy. In short, tongue speaking is prophecy, as the Bible says it. It's just that it is without interpretation. When it is with interpretation, you will understand that what I'm saying through tongues is the Holy Ghost speaking. If I begin to say through tongues, that thing can be, oh Lord, arise, bless your children, oh Lord, arise. But I'm speaking it in tongues, Holy Ghost, He transcends, He helps me to pray. acting, you know, not a worldly this thing. I believe in it. It is not bad. It is good. It's a ministry. Praise God. Somebody that has the ministry, you know, the maybe teaching of choir, singing, a good wonderful voice, that's a ministry. Am I called pit here? Because many times, many people, when they hear ministry, what comes into their mind is pulpit. Pulpit. Let listen to me. I will say it again. You see this pulpit? Many people would have gone to heaven if they have left this pulpit. Are you hearing me? If I want to kill you, it's very easy. And how I will kill you is very easy. I will just give you what you don't have grace for. For example, let me say, bro, let me not use somebody's name. Let me say a brother has the calling of an evangelist. Then I make him a pastor. I'm killing you. I'm just killing you. No, I'm just killing you. The way Satan will attack you, nobody will protect you. There is no covering, no angelic power to protect you. As I am ministering to you, I'm being God. I have a mighty angel that is standing for me, that stands to protect me. I have a mighty angel. So that's why no matter what comes my way, it doesn't bother me. I don't fight people, if you do better, I don't leave you alone. But what I know is that there is an anointing that fights for the minister. And it is very terrible. You know, listen to me. There are some certain things you will do to a pastor. God can hold it for your generations to come. Are you hearing? It's very dangerous. Never you speak against an anointed person. Never you, except God has given you the power to speak. Praise God. But don't do it, it's dangerous. You are laying a bad foundation for yourself. Do you know that there are many people that are lying spiritually because of one or two words or gossip they said about the pastor or a minister of God? And don't mind that, that's what they do. Maybe he has committed fornication or adultery. I'll not be laughing. You just kill yourself. You will just die. Because it's a spiritual thing. As you are saying that thing, the callings and the anointing now will be going. You cannot, it is impossible to cause the hands that blesses you. Praise God. You can't do it to your father. That's why your parents, you should never get to an area in your life where you stand up against your father and say, Papa, what's wrong with you? I will hear you. If that man causes you, it is over for you. No pastor will relieve you from it. You don't do it. There are many people today suffering because of a cause their parents laid on them. You steal from your parents and your mother say it will never be well with you. That's so it don't deal. It don't happen. Until you know who Jesus is, for Jesus to release that thing from you, it will be there. Many people don't know what they are doing. I pray God will help us so that we will be able to give the elders a woman. Praise God. Praise God. So I just lay principles for us on ministry. Some people can be called into a ministry of writing. You say it's little. There are some people that have grace when it comes to writing. If they just write an article for me, the way they will present it, somebody will receive compassion. As I'm saying this, it's not going the area God has called you to. That thing you see and you have joy doing it. Not the one that you are doing. Are you crying? Why the pastor tell me to do this thing now? Why the pastor tell me to do this thing? You have joy. You have peace. You are enjoying it. You are feeling His presence when you're doing it. Praise God. Somebody can ever have the ministry of painting and drawing. Though it's a talent. But now, you can make it to be a gift. Channel it into a spiritual thing. Maybe what you'll be doing for the church is just to be drawing something about Jesus love you, putting it everywhere, Jesus love you. Somebody will get converted. Praise God. Some people have the ministry of support. Their only calling is to support the ministers. Their only calling is to support the pastors. Support the leaders. That's their only calling in life. The more they do it, the more they will be blessed financially. There are people that have this calling. That's their only calling. Their only calling is to be taking care of the ministers. Every month on a monthly basis, they do it. joy. Not that they are doing that, say, is it not because of me, pastor is enjoying? Is it not because of me, all the pastors they are feeding? No, it's not because of you. You are not doing a favor for God. God is doing a favor for you because he's blessing you in return. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Because many of us, because that's why we need apostles in the church. So direct our path. There are people that sit like that. See now our tithes are offering. Do you think? Oh God. By the grace of God, since 2016, those almost since I even came to the Lord. I'm only saying 2016, but let me say since I came, because it's not possible. When I first came to the Lord, my parents, they almost cursed me. When they realize that out of my pocket money, I'm giving tithes and offering inside my school pocket money in university. You know what I mean? If you are a child of God, they don't force you to do things. You know what to do. It's because some people don't have the Holy Spirit. When you have the Holy Spirit, nobody should tell you. You already know what to do. The Bible says the anointing teaches you what? Bible students, all things. Praise God. It is impossible for me to. It cannot happen. It's not in this life. Maybe it's when we enter heaven. It's impossible. It cannot be that a month will pass. I will not give my offering and tithe to God. You know, you want to hear my story. I'm doing it with joy. Praise God. And I'm even doing it to the extent that I don't want it. I don't want somebody. I want to do it big. That's my life. Praise God. I'm enjoying it. There are people that have come to me. A brother came to me and said, man of God, as you did now, millions. That's what you should have. You should be here. I laugh. I said, do you think I'm doing all these things by my power? I say I'm on a covenant with God. So what God is doing for me is that he separates me from problem. Where others will be spending their money, I'm not spending my money. Are you hearing me? That's what God does for you when you have a giving spirit. Where others are spending money, you will not spend your money. Somebody is receiving $1,000. Then you spend $300 on your children's sickness. You now have sickness. You spend $200 on it. Before you know a problem here, accident here, this one here. You don't have money. You don't have any money. The person that even has $500 is better than you. And you see, it's not about quantity. It's about being in favor with God. For the eyes of the Lord are always on the righteous. When God's eye is on you, his eyes are always on the righteous. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. Some people are called into that ministry. Health, you know, financiers. Some people are called into a media ministry. When you tell them to do the media work, they know how to do it very well. In short, as they are doing it, people will be receiving salvation from it. Praise God. People will be receiving salvation. A lot of ministries like that. Some are called to be error. You must not be number one to be effective. You can be number two and be effective. One of the men that I respect so much, he might not be in holiness, is a man called Abioye. I respect him and I see it. I've never seen a man like that. As you see that man, in church in Abuja, that's the, let me say, the assistant to Oyedepo. His church in Abuja is bigger than many so-called general overseers. They have told the man, leave this ministry now, go and start your own. You know what the man said? He said, no, I can't do it. This is my father. God has called me to be here. I said, I've never seen a human being like him before. And then you see the man, the humility in his eyes. This man is a bishop. They call him bishop. But he has never claimed equality to be the settler in that church. Never. In short, the same man will tell you, this man has never given me problem in my life in this church. But he gives up building. Paul says, they look for their own. That's not how to build. Praise God. Now you are sitting there, I've come to, I've traveled to Abuja, you know, I've gone there, I've traveled there to do a lot, some certain things. I go there to spend some time, you know, retreat and all that. In short, there is very huge and mighty. People tell him, ah, leave this church now. In short, if that man is, sorry to say, there are a lot of things that will happen. He says, no, I can't do it. It's unjust, it's unrighteous. Because many times we don't understand something. That the grace of God that is working many times comes from the anointing in a particular commission. Praise God. And then you might not understand. Sometimes, so when you begin to separate yourself, you begin to lose grip of that covering. May not be so in your life in the name of Jesus. It's like when you stop being a Christian and serving Jesus, you think the covering of Jesus will be upon you. No, no, no. The covering of Jesus will not be upon you. Praise God. So I want you to fulfill a glorious ministry. I want you to be great. Ask all of my workers, ask from Christian. I tell them, I say, I want you to be rich. I want you to be better than me. Be great. I don't care. But I want you to be useful in the kingdom of God. That's what I want. Because a father always wants his children to be great. But not be rebellious. Not be treated in a cunning way. Not be playing an alarm's foundation. Such kind of things don't last. I can tell you the end from the beginning. That's why I relax. Because I know it will not last. Are you fulfilling the calling and ministry of God upon your life? Oh God. I wish I can be going into the sweeping ministry. I wish I can go into sweeping ministry and be sweeping and be cleaning. Because that's what I do in the Catholic Church. Sweeping and be cleaning statues. Sweeping and be cleaning chair. Sweeping and be cleaning St. Augustine statue. And Mary, Mother Mary statue. I do it and I'm happy. No, I sweep the compound of the church. Everybody knows. They say, triplets. He's sweeping the church. I do it and I'm happy. I'm not looking at anybody. Nobody's looking at me. I clean the Reverend Father's grotto. We go to his car. We clean his car. We do everything here. You know, the Reverend Father calls. Oh God. You know what thing I've realized? See, you can say some bad things about the Catholic Church, but there's something I've realized they have. Orderliness. You can't take it away from the Catholic Church. They have orderliness. You dare not speak against a bishop. They will just. You know what they will do to you in the Catholic Church? Those people are very, very, they are disciplined though. They don't do things like we, Protestant church here. Or maybe you speak to the Pope. It's like you have done a grievous sin. Am I saying that you should have done a man? No! I'm only telling you administration and orderliness in the church. Paul says, when I come, let there be orderliness. Why is it that some people are prophesying? Some people are speaking in tongues? Some people are doing this? If an apostle does not put orderliness, the church will be scattered. Praise God. Praise God. Are we understanding something here? Somebody says it's confusing. Let me tell you something. See one thing about this God. God will allow you to do some certain things. When you get to heaven, you will report back to him. Somebody say there are some women starting big ministries. No problem. It's not now. When you get to heaven, you understand better. You understand better. Starting big ministries and they are wearing trousers. And because you are seeing miracles, you are seeing signs and wonders. Go to heaven. When you go to heaven, you will answer. God, this is what they will do to you when you die. When you die, they begin to open scriptures. Okay, let's look at 1 Peter 3 verse 3. You too, you will read it. Then God will ask you. Look at this. You went against the word. You have derailed people. And because of you, 100 men were lost. Let me tell you something. There is a reason why women must be careful. Listen carefully. You know I'm not like you. When a brother is seen a woman, do you know that you can lead many to hell? By the time a woman begins to preach and begins to shake, I just need you to understand some things. And then she begins to shake, all her body begins to shake, all the parts begin to shake. Somebody will be looking, thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. I'm telling you, before you know it, you think I'm not worried, you will not understand what I'm saying. But with time, you will understand. Before you know it, that person. going to get. Don't worry.
Just calm down.
We have many things to look at.
Will,
in this series of ministry, we'll look at a woman's ministry. We are trying to build the women's ministry to be strong in our church so that you can do a lot of mighty works. But it must be partnered with scriptures. Praise God. It must be partnered with scriptures. I've seen a woman. The wife reported to me. She said, "What should I do?" I tell her, "There's nothing you can do here. I can't help you." The woman went to think the husband is working as a personal assistant to the woman in the ministry there. They are doing their personal assistance inside the bedroom. So when the woman reported, she's crying, "My husband," I said, "I can't do anything." You know why? She has used the anointing in the wrong way to hold your husband. "I cannot do anything, only God can help you." There is a mystery about the anointing. This thing we call anointing has power. But if you abuse your power, God will deal with you. Are you hearing me? What did I say? The anointing has what? Power. But if you abuse your power, God will deal with you. The woman has changed the man though. But what do you want me to do? She's using anointing. But she's using it in the wrong way. There is what is called a corrupted anointing. As time goes on, you will understand better. I will explain better. An anointing can be corrupted. And it will not serve eternal value. Instead, it will cause destruction. Satan has an anointing. But you know his anointing is corrupted. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. So, look at that. What have you been called? Some of you, there are things in you. There are things you can do inside of you. So, build the church. Some of you, you are good in management. If we tell you to arrange this chair, maybe if we tell you to arrange chairs now, I will just scatter everywhere. But if we tell you to do it, you are still good at it. You know, there are some people that spirit of putting things in order and management is just inside of them, mostly women. Women have that wonderful kind of ministry. Women can put things in order very well. Me, I'm not like that, though. I can scatter everywhere. Just like me, I don't. But a woman will put things orderly. See the way she arranges the plates. See the way me arrange my plates. I just scatter everywhere. But she will arrange the plates, put the bed in a nice place, put the this. Is a ministry to you, might not understand. Because she can use it in the church and put this in order. And when people come to the service, they say, "Wow, glory be to God." Some people have the ministry of an usher. They can stand. They have the grace of standing. Why some people, if they stand for 30 minutes, they will just collapse. Some can stand 5 hours. It's a calling. In those days in the Catholic Church, I was a church warden. I want you to know that when I was in the old religion, I was an active person. I was a church warden. If I see you sleeping in church, they know me now. Because I have this, even though I was not born again, there is this spirit of holiness inside of me. When I see two people, boy and girl talking to each other, I say, "God," they know, they say, "He has come again. He don't destroy our gathering together." And once I see boy and girl talking, me, I really understand. Say, inside church, Reverend Father is preaching, people are talking. I know what to do. I will do it in such a way that people will see them and say, okay. It's a ministry. Praise God. Praise God. Maybe I will not be able to overemphasize this because of time. What is your calling and ministry? If God has given you grace, maybe of an evangelist, why don't you use it in the church and work in the church? The problem with human beings is, must you? Why can't you build the church without gifts? This gifting brings about pride if you are not being taught. I told myself, and let me say it here, it will take me time for me to ordain somebody in this church again. Because I've learned my lesson. I've made mistakes. But I will be careful next time not to make mistakes again. I've made mistakes. I've made terrible mistakes. I shouldn't have made those mistakes. But possibly because I am growing, I don't know so much. I'm learning. We all learn day by day. Praise God. Because I've come to realize people must be taught. They must be discipled. They must learn. The Bible says you don't take a notice and put it in a higher position of authority. Lest what? Bible student, he be lifted up with pride, which is the sin of the devil. Are you seeing that? This thing we call gifts, ministry, calling, it can take you to hellfire. Straight hellfire. And the punishment that you will receive here. Oh my God. There are some ministries today that would have won 10,000 souls. But because that brother or sister did not know God has called him or her there to win that 10,000 souls. Those 10,000 souls will not be saved. When they die, God will ask, should I take you to heaven? Look at you. It was because of you. This thing happened here. This soul, this particular soul, I wanted to use this soul to win 5,000 souls. Because of you and because of your selfishness, this soul did not come to the kingdom. Should I take you to heaven? See what the person can answer. God, you are a just God. I should not go to heaven. Please let me go to hellfire. I know you. What I'm telling you is the truth. That is how they answer in the spiritual world when they die. They tell God, I'm not able to, I should not be in heaven. Take me to hellfire. You will never be a portion in the name of Jesus. You will never be a portion in the name of Jesus. You will never be a portion in the name of Jesus. You will never be a portion in the name of Jesus. You will never be a portion in the name of Jesus. You will never be a portion in the name of Jesus. From earth to heaven, not from earth to hellfire. From earth to where? Heaven. From a glory to another glory. The Lord wants to do this in our life. The Lord wants to build us. What is that thing God has put to you? Sister, what is that thing God has put to you? Brother, maybe you can sing. You have been giving a good voice. Then we call you to sing. Say, Master, I can't sing now. You know, you think it's me you are doing. You are doing yourself. You are doing yourself. You know, some of you young people, I watch you in this church. I see some of the things you do. I shake my head. I say, God, just is maturity. When you grow in maturity, you will understand. It's because now, maybe you are still behaving like babies. That's how babies behave. So it's like somebody's telling you, come and give glory to God. Then you say, I can't give glory to God. No, I can't give glory. God will look at you from heaven. And he will shake his head. It will not be so in your life in the name of Jesus. What has God called you for? What has God called you for? I only just said a few here. Some people support, church support in different dimensions. God has called them there. What has God called you for, sister? What has God called you for? There are some people, God called them to administration. Administration is that they know how to set things in order. Do you know, being an advisor is a ministry. Like Ahithophel to David. Praise God. Do you know presidents have what is called advisor? It's not wrong. There are ministers and general overseers, they have their advisors. Most times, some of them, their advisors are their wives. Praise God. It's a ministry. Are we getting something here? Are we getting something here? And what my fellowship, are we getting something here? Or some of you are not happy. They are like, oh, what is the power of God teaching us again? Hey, that thing I want to do now, I cannot do it very well now. Man of God, what is he teaching? I'm helping you. I'm doing it because I love you. I'm doing it because I understand what I'm teaching you. Praise God. I want you to grow. I told you that there is a revival in heaven. The revival is to grow spiritually. To grow. I want you to be taught. When you pass like somebody challenges you, you say, no, I'm not a baby, I understand you, but I know what I'm doing. know what I'm doing. I will not allow, and I will not allow it. For there are things I will not even allow here.